Okay, so welcome back everybody to the last video in this series. This part, which is a bit shorter, I will show you how to get an unbiased estimator for the variance sigma squared. So let's jump straight in. Remind you, our model was y is x beta plus epsilon, and the epsilon were assumed to be normal distributed, and the sigma squared shows up here in the covariance, namely the components of the vector epsilon are assumed to be independent, and each of them has variance sigma squared. There is an effect which already shows in the one-dimensional case of simple linear regression, namely we have estimates for the epsilon I. So we have epsilon I hat is yi minus yi hat, and the epsilon hat estimates the epsilon, so one could think our estimator should be 1 over n minus 1 sum I from 1 to n epsilon hat I minus epsilon hat bar, right, for the average or so, squared. That's how you would normally estimate variance, but that, it turns out, is not how it goes, but it's nearly how it goes. So first, one can show that this term here, that is 0, is not there. So if we continue with this thought, we would get 1 over n minus 1 sum I from 1 to n epsilon I hat squared, or 1 over n minus 1 sum I from 1 to n yi minus yi hat squared. And it turns out that nearly works, but does not quite work. So what one needs to do instead is one needs to adjust this prefactor a bit. And what one needs is n minus p minus 1 here. And I show you that with this prefactor, the estimator is unbiased. So we are considering this estimator with the adjusted prefactor, and I'm going to show you the expectation of this thing if we plug in y from the model equals sigma squared. Good, let's do that. So I start here. Yi minus yi hat squared, and that summed up. Need to worry about the prefactor in a second. That is the Euclidean length of y minus y hat squared. And that's y minus y hat transpose y minus y hat. Good. So that's just new notation. Then y minus y hat is y minus hy. The hat matrix turns y into y hat is identity minus hat matrix applied to y. We can use this here. So we have identity minus hat matrix y transpose. I made a mistake here earlier, I fixed it. Times identity minus hy is y transpose identity minus h transpose identity minus hy. And you will recognize this from the section about the hat matrix. First, we don't need this transpose, so we have y transpose identity minus hat identity minus hat y, and then we showed that's idempotent, so we have y transpose identity minus h y. So that's using the rules for the hat matrix we had a whole separate video for. Now our next step is we have to plug in the model. So using y is x beta plus epsilon, we get sum I from 1 to n yi minus, not sure whether that should now be capital or not, y hat I squared is, now it goes in here, only see y is now capital. So that is x beta plus epsilon transpose identity minus h x beta plus epsilon. And now we have four terms if I expand this and that bracket. So we do epsilon transpose identity minus h epsilon plus beta transpose x transpose identity minus h epsilon plus epsilon transpose identity minus h x beta plus beta transpose x transpose identity minus h x beta. And now we have seen identity minus h x equals 0. that was property 6. So this term goes away because it has identity minus h, x. Then this term here actually equals that one. It looks like it's a transpose, but it's numbers. So transposing doesn't do anything. So that also goes away by virtue of being identical to that. And similarly, here is an I minus h, x. So this term goes away. And the only thing we are left with is this term. And this term here, we have just done in the previous video. We know if we divide it by sigma squared, then we get a chi-squared distribution with n minus p minus 1 degrees of freedom. So let's do the dividing. 1 over sigma squared, sum I from 1 to n, yi minus y hat I squared is 1 over sigma squared epsilon transpose identity minus hat matrix epsilon is Cochran's theorem says chi-squared distributed with n minus p minus 1 degrees of freedom. And in the video about Cochran's theorem, I mentioned the expectation of a chi-squared distribution equals the number of degrees of freedom. So expectation of all of this equals n minus p minus 1. Good, and now we are there because expectation of sigma hat square or estimator is expectation of 1 over n minus p minus 1 sum I from 1 to n yi minus y hat I squared. And now you see how we need to adjust this result. We first need to divide by n minus p minus 1, so it cancels this. That term here is really the reason why we have this prefactor. And here we are dividing by sigma squared. So we need to not have a sigma squared, multiply the right-hand side with sigma squared. So let's do both. So that's n minus p minus 1. I said we need to divide by n minus p minus 1 and multiply with sigma squared. So we get sigma squared. And that now finally shows that this estimator is unbiased because sigma squared is the truth. And that's the expectation of the estimator, so bias sigma hat squared is expected value minus truth is 0 for this case. So that is this section done. And now we know how to estimate all parameters of the model. We knew already for a while how to estimate beta, and we learned now this estimator is unbiased. And we have newly also learned how to estimate sigma squared from the model. And we have also seen that new estimator is also unbiased. So that was a lot of work, but we are done for now. So I will leave you to this, maybe read the notes again. And I'll see you again in a new video in a few days' time. So thank you all and goodbye.